people. I've been wanting to make this video on the Matthew effect for a while, but I haven't had time as I was moving into my new apartment. So here goes. I'm going to read you the Matthew effect as is, and then I'll try and translate it as best I can. Right? So the Matthew effect says, "For unto everyone that hath shall be given, and he shall have abundance. But from him that hath not shall be taken away that which he hath." So I saw a really kind of not very good summary. Rich get richer, poor get poor. So you can say rich get richer, poor get poor, but it's actually bigger than that. If you look, you see people, athletes, those who are strong get stronger, those who are quick get quicker. You can see it in other domains, those who are good with women end up being better with women, those who are bad with women end up being worse with women. So this Matthew effect, you can use it and analyze it in every spectrum of life. Those who are healthy get healthier, those who are sick get more sick. So our goal in using the Matthew effect is to try and get on the positive end at anything we're trying to achieve, which is to see if you're trying to achieve financial wealth, start saving your money, start investing your money, and start seeing it grow. If your objective is strength, start doing exercises which make you stronger and build on that strength with every progressive workout and every progressive week. If your objective is flexibility, same thing. Build on your flexibility from day to day, from week to week. If your goal is to be smoother with the opposite sex, just try talking to them, and then you'll be smoother still following day, following week, following month. So it works on every possible area. When you're starting to eat better, you're gonna wanna eat even more better, or when you start eating worse, you're gonna tend to wanna crave foods that make you eat worse. So the Matthew effect is a very powerful kind of theory to analyze, because it works in many, many different domains. So if you look, the rich do get richer, and the poor do get poorer, but it's bigger than that. It goes on every possible aspect, right? If you notice somebody that's starting to age quick, they start to age even quicker with the passing years. Somebody who starts to look like they're becoming youthful, they start becoming youthful. I mean, obviously, those things have a plateau, but nonetheless, for many, many years, it could work out in that fashion. So, what you wanna do is take the Matthew effect, analyze an area of your life which is floundering or weak, and then try and put yourself on the positive side of the Matthew effect. Try and find a way to make gains in that area of your life which is lacking. So if it's self-confidence, try and put yourself in an area where the Matthew effect is giving from you and not taking away. So this person, Matthew from the Bible, it's not like he invented this theory, right? It's out there in our day-to-day world. Right? You see a guy with a nice sports car, next year you'll probably have a nicer sports car. The guy who can't pay his rent, probably get evicted. So this is how the Matthew effect works. You want to try your best to use it on a conscious level so that you put yourself on the positive end to it and you start making the gains in every area of your life that you want. So, very important, analyze what areas of your life are on the negative end of the Matthew effect and then try and turn it into a positive. Also, try and analyze what areas in your life are on the positive end of the Matthew effect and keep going in that direction. Use whatever system you're using in the positive area to improve the negative areas. Also, we have to look at something very important, whether we like it or not. When you're moving towards something, unfortunately, you're moving away towards something else. Just try your best in your life when you're moving towards something that you're moving towards something more positive than the thing you are leaving behind. In many cases, some people attract the thing they want, they gain the thing they want, so they're in the positive side of the Matthew effect, but then they're not noticing that other areas of their life are going in the negative. Example, so you're starting to make money, you're starting to work hard, you have more work, you're making more money, but your family life is suffering, and so your family life is getting worse and worse and worse every day. Try and keep these things balanced and try and make them move forward together if possible. And if you notice that you're moving way towards something and way behind and you're leaving something far away behind, right? Try and keep them kind of synergistically moving forward. And also use this Matthew effect to get the things you want, right? Don't make it that you wake up one day and you lost the really important things in your life, right? Because it'll do that. If you're not looking, one day you'll lose all the important things that you weren't paying attention to. But if you're focused, it'll help you gain all the things that you've been wanting to gain. So remember, use it to get to where you want to go, and use it to leave behind the things that you don't want, and try to pay attention if you're not being conscious and you're leaving behind things that you do want, and you're not going forward towards things that you do want.